Traditional labor is deeply dysfunctional and exploitative, so we should all just quit our jobs and start a YouTube channel, right? That's the position of many here on YouTube who collectively have become known as the I don't dream of work crowd. And I have some complicated feelings on the matter. Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts to benefit your body and brain. And today, I am diving into a topic way beyond flow arts, but it's also one that I think I can offer some perspective on. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spinballs, and Ultra Poi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. And a special thanks to the first non-business friend of the channel, Johnny Howard. Thanks so much for your support, Johnny. Hey friends, so my guess is that if you're a regular viewer of this channel, then this video is going to feel like a bit of a left turn. Pun not intended. I don't normally talk about bigger YouTube trends for a lot of reasons, but I decided to make an exception here because I felt like this was actually a topic that I could talk about from a place of some degree of knowledge. Maybe I'll talk about broader topics more often in the future. We shall have to see. But what y'all really came here for was a discussion of the I don't dream of work problem as it's been formulated and solved by several different YouTube channels out there. A very brief summary of the problem is as such. The economy has been structured in such a way that most, if not all, labor is exploitative. There's no such thing as a dream job because many don't dream of simply giving up their labor for systems that exploit them. And as such, there's no point in full engagement in this economy. The solution? To tune out and work for yourself. That is, start a YouTube channel. Those familiar with this problem will almost certainly be a tad miffed that I have summarized it so briefly, and that is 100% deliberate. Not because I want to suggest that the problem doesn't exist, or that those who've taken up this position are simpletons, but because there are a bunch of creators out there that have done fantastic work summarizing this philosophy far better than I ever could, and I'd rather support them than compete with them. I've linked to several such creators down in the description whose work I've consulted both to get an overview of this problem as well as many of the points for and against it. Please go check out their videos, not just to get a better understanding of the issue, but also because I think their content is exemplary. So given that nearly a decade ago, I left gainful employment to pursue flow arts full-time and run my own YouTube channel, you'd think I'd be on this team, right? Well, yes. And no. Look, it's complicated, okay? So I'm going to start this off by saying that I'm not going to litigate the problems outlined by some of the people that I've linked to. For Harriet in particular has pretty exhaustively documented not just how huge a problem income inequality has become in the post-war period, but also the many complaints about the current labor market. I will not contest any of this. That data is out there and it's really hard to argue with. What I am going to contest is the solution that many in this camp have put out there. And I want to be 100% clear about this. YouTube is not the solution. I know, not what you were expecting, was it? So let me break down why. I'll start this off by saying that I do get where this push is coming from. After all, I held a traditional job when I first moved to DC that I found incredibly unfulfilling and tedious. Even though I was engaged in nonprofit work, I was really sad to discover just how dependent that work is on the whims of people in power, their egos, and the politics of a given moment, to say nothing of how rigid a workplace I was in and how few opportunities there were for me to contribute creatively to the work of the organization. When I finally left, I did so for a creative endeavor that felt much more fulfilling, despite its lack of mainstream respectability or visibility. And I have never worked harder in my life than I did when I became self-employed. My first day not being traditionally employed was one that I will never forget, because it was real fun for about the first hour. And then it was really, really not. See, you kind of take it for granted at a traditional job that you can have a case of the Mondays. You can have a morning where you kind of dick around a bit and don't really get much done. But when you're self-employed, every moment that you're not directly working on something that's going to make you money is a moment that you're not paying rent or able to get groceries. There was a kind of anxiety that started up that day that I had never known in my life before that, and it's never gone completely away. I'm grateful now that I have several passive income streams that keep me afloat when I'm having writer's block or a bad week for other reasons, but that anxiety is nearly always there in the background. And honestly, I'm kind of grateful that it is. Because here's the thing. Whether it's a YouTube channel, an Etsy shop, hell, even an OnlyFans channel, what you're fundamentally doing is you're starting a business. Businesses are hard to run. It's something of a cliche that nearly every engineer, designer, or craftsperson at a company looks at the people running it and swears that they can do a better job. Many try and quickly discover that there's a reason that there are so many individual roles at a company, because you need people that specialize in a variety of different skills to make a company run. Designers, manufacturers, marketers, human resources, and yes, even executive functions too. This is where the progressive members of my audience are going to roast me in effigy, but it has to be said. Executive roles are an entire skill set in and of themselves, and it's one of the most difficult skills to train and be good at. Good leaders are worth it. Many businesses fail within the first 5 years, and this is a big part of the reason why. A huge percentage of the person starting them have grossly underestimated the skills and resources necessary in order to make that business function. Now, this is not me saying that people are too stupid to learn these skills. Far from it. All of these are skills that can be either learned or outsourced. Heck, Drex Factor Poi has an org chart with a list of positions necessary to keep it running as a business. I happen to occupy nearly all of them, but they exist nonetheless. But doesn't this mean that you're at least liberated from the yoke of unsympathetic managers who become proxies for the system that they prop up? Spoilers, just because you work for yourself, that doesn't mean you're not working for an asshole. Setting up your own channel does not set you free of the constraints of traditional capitalism. It means that you have to learn more roles within it, and that you have to do so without the many safety nets that exist within traditional employment. There's no PTO, no sick days, no vacation days. Health insurance, if you're an American, is absurdly expensive if it's even possible at all. There is an absurd amount of risk in starting a channel full-time. And that's not even getting into how complicated a picture it is to suggest that people start YouTube channels of all things in order to escape traditional labor. Now, overall, I'm a big fan of YouTube. I've seen a lot, and I do mean a lot of creators start channels and thrive with them, who would have been excluded from traditional labor markets, whether due to racism, ableism, homophobia, transphobia, or sexism. I think that it is so cool that I can get all of their perspectives on this platform and that they can meaningfully engage with our society through their content and contribute their voice where traditional media might have filtered it out. But YouTube is not simply an open marketplace of ideas. There is the almighty algorithm. It changes constantly and frequently at the expense of the relationships that many people have created with their viewers. Making a living on YouTube is freaking hard, and there is a new challenge to doing so every single day. This will be true of any other platform too. You don't escape this on Instagram or TikTok. You merely trade off one set of filters on what gets seen for another. Now, all that said, I also have to stick in a little note here, because I also have to check my privilege in this discussion. As an able-bodied, cishet white male, I have never been excluded from traditional labor for any reason beyond my control. I don't have a lot of perspective on the difficulties people outside my Venn diagram of privilege face in traditional labor, so the problems that I'm outlining here could very easily be insignificant compared to those faced in attempting to engage in traditional labor for many. Your mileage may vary. One of the videos that I've linked to in the description from FD Signifier does an absolutely amazing job of talking about the intersectionality of this problem. Please go check it out, because it's good to keep in mind that this problem only gets more complicated when viewed through this lens. Also, the guy's content is fantastic. Give him a sub either way. But all that said, I think it's a mistake to simply tell people that the solution to these problems is to start a YouTube channel. There's a whole mess of complications they're signing up for there that are not clear from the way that this problem is being framed. And yet, so I'm gonna have it both ways. Yes. Kind of. Quite a few of you that are regular viewers might be ready to call me a hypocrite, because in the past year, I've either taught or helped teach several courses on using social media as a means to generate passive income. Guilty as charged. Yes, I have advocated for exactly the thing that the I Don't Dream of Labor crowd is advocating for as well. Build passive income and create content. And here's why. If you're up for the challenge of it, there are a lot of ways in which being a content creator and being your own boss can be very rewarding. To say nothing of the fact that the more voices we add representing more viewpoints, I think the better educated we're all going to wind up becoming. And even more specifically, the more people there are creating Flow Arts content, the more people they in turn are going to inspire, and the more our community will grow. And even more than that, one of my great frustrations with many on the left, and even more specifically with many people within my niches of flow arts and burner culture, is that entrepreneurship is something that's so frequently stigmatized. There are so many people that avoid engaging in it because they believe that there's no way to do it ethically. The classic version of this I see time and time again is the people that decide they want to create a nonprofit for whatever project they're working on simply because they believe that it signals that their intentions are noble. Side note. Unless you really need people giving you money to be able to write that off on their taxes, you do not need to be a nonprofit. Being a nonprofit does not inherently make your mission noble. There's no shortage of exploitative NGOs out there. Hashtag not legal or business advice. But here's the problem when you stigmatize entrepreneurship and position it as the opposite of ethical community engagement. You guarantee that the only people interested in doing it will be doing so for unethical reasons. If there's a social stigma to starting a business, that means that the people most likely to do so are those that don't care about the social stigma. People that don't care about risking that stigma are also those with the least amount of investment into the community that they're doing business in. And as such, there are few incentives for them to do so in a way that is fair to everyone. Rather than steering people away from unethical business practices, you've essentially guaranteed that it's the only possible outcome by draining the lake until only the bottom feeders are left. Also, shout out to Hank Green for formulating that observation. Super helpful. So if the worst thing that comes out of I Don't Dream of Labor is that we get a whole bunch of people starting businesses with YouTube channels that aren't simply there to take advantage of their audience, yeah, I mean, there's much worse outcomes than that. A sizable percentage of them will discover they aren't escaping work, but signing up for a whole lot more of it, and they'll wind up washing out in the end because of it. But those that stay, they're going to be people that really want to make sure that they're on the right side of most issues, and they're also going to be those that are most likely to take care of their people. So what's your take? Does this movement create unrealistic expectations of being able to exit the traditional labor market at the expense of the hopes and dreams of many? Or is it a harmless enough way to get more people interested in entrepreneurship? I'd love to hear your thoughts. If you stuck around this long, I hope that means that you'd like to see more content from me in the future. So please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share to help me out with that dastardly algorithm and, of course, to help people find my content. Real quick, I just wanted to throw out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind support of these wonderful people right here. These are my Flow patrons over on Patreon, and they, along with the people listed down in the description, help to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. Do you like Poi content? Do you like tutorials, flow sessions, and vlogs on flow arts culture? Consider signing up to support my work. I want to bring flow arts to the wider world and help people connect with their brains and their bodies through prop spinning. So help me do it. Head on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and sign up. You can do that either by clicking on the card that just popped up on YouTube or by using the link down in the description. Not only will you be supporting this mission, but you'll also be able to get early access to all of my content, a vote in what content I produce in the future, and a host of other awesome rewards such as getting a special weekly poi lesson delivered to your inbox every week that is available only to my supporters. Go give that a look and please consider supporting this channel. Thank you in advance. Goodness, the comments on this are going to be real interesting to read. Let's see how that turns out. Anyways, if you'd like to see more videos I've created on the topic of entrepreneurship and more specifically how it can be done within the flow arts, I'll include a link to a playlist on other videos I've done down in the description as well as up on screen if you're watching on YouTube. If you have no idea what the flow arts are, please stick around because they're super fun and I hope I can convince you to give them a go. In the meantime, thank you for watching and have yourself a good one. Peace.